Welcome to Open Heaven Daily Devotional Study. Today's date, Wednesday, January 4th, 2023. Topic, When God Breathes Part 2. Shall we pray, O Lord in heaven, we appreciate the privilege we have to study your word. Let the word of God we hear today fall upon a fertile place in our hearts in Jesus' name. Amen. Memory verse, 2 Samuel 22 16. And the channels of the sea appeared, the foundations of the world were discovered, at the rebuking of the Lord, at the blast of the breath of his nostrils. Bible reading is taken from 2 Samuel 22 verses 16 to 25. 16, And the channels of the sea appeared, the foundations of the world were discovered, at the rebuking of the Lord, at the blast of the breath of his nostrils. 17 He sent from above, he took me, he drew me out of many waters. 18 He delivered me from my strong enemy, and from them that hated me, for they were too strong for me. 19 They prevented me in the day of my calamity, but the Lord was my stay. 20 He brought me forth also into a large place, he delivered me because he delighted in me. 21 The Lord rewarded me according to my righteousness, according to the cleanness of my hands hath he recompensed me. 22 For I have kept the ways of the Lord, and have not wickedly departed from my God. 23 For all his judgments were before me, and as for his statutes, I did not depart from them. 24 I was also upright before him, and have kept myself from mine iniquity. 25 Therefore the Lord hath recompensed me according to my righteousness, according to my cleanness in his eyesight. Our topic again is When God Breathes Part 2. Message: When God decides to breathe for the sake of someone, he may not do so directly on the individual, rather, he could breathe heavily to blow away the fellow's enemies. Whenever you see the Bible say a blast of his nostrils, that is God breathing heavily to blow away the enemies of his children, as we see in Exodus 15 verses 8 to 10. With the blast of his nostrils, he parted the Red Sea that was standing in the way of the Israelites to the promised land, and then he made the water return, to drown Pharaoh and his army. When God breathes against your enemies, not only will they be no more, but you will also be established in the place of your destiny. David testified to this in verse 20 of today's Bible reading. He brought me forth also into a large place, he delivered me because he delighted in me. With one breath, the Lord cleared off all David's enemies and also brought him into a large place. Do you know that God can do the same for you today? He can clear off all your enemies and take you to that same place that they have been trying to stop you from getting to. Now, I have always said that the summary of all Jesus' messages in the Bible is that nothing goes for nothing. In other words, there are always conditions to be met for everything that we expect God to do for us. What is the condition for God to breathe against our enemies and to lead us to the glorious end he has set ahead of us? It is in verses 21 to 25 of our Bible reading Holiness. David said the Lord rewarded him according to his righteousness and the cleanliness of his hands. Are your hands clean? When a person is faced with enemy forces he or she cannot defeat, an ally stronger than the enemy forces would be required to guarantee victory. The ally would, however, withdraw their support if the person offends them. Don't offend your ally, don't do things that will make the Lord refuse to fight for you. Prayer point. Father, please help me to live holy. Lord, breathe against all my enemies so that I can fulfill my destiny, in Jesus' name. O Lord, please help me to live holy. Lord, breathe against all my enemies so that I can fulfill my destiny, in Jesus' name. I will fulfill my destiny. Amen. Bible in 1 year, Genesis 13-17. Our hymn today is hymn 10. In Christ Alone.
This